そうね、最初のシーンに関しては福島のことは考えてなかったです。あれは
So for the first scene, it wasn't, he really didn't have that Fukushima in mind. The stacks and like the chimney and the smoke, it's just a very traditional Japanese funeral style. But, but he does have a mention of Fukushima later on, and when he says that he wanted to use it in a way that wasn't too, it didn't have too much meaning. You know, look at it as a flat perspective, you know, to say neither it's bad or good.
ちょっと名前を出してます。
So the fighting fish, it's also because it's a fighting fish, it's a very lonely fish because they have to be kept by themselves. And so, you know, in the story, Hikari finds friends to survive with. But because they're in reality, there are also people who don't have such, you know, friends that they can, you know, connect with to survive. He wanted to give them kind of a, you know, a, like a to cheer them on, to show by showing that the fish can, you know, survive in such murky waters.
ひかりくんに共感するとこもあって、
If his parents were to, you know, pass away, he would feel very sad. But at the same time, he thinks that he might become kind of a zombie himself. But he thinks that the message, one of the message, important message of the film is that, you know, life goes on.
音は普通はやらないですけど3、4ヶ月ぐらいずっと音だけの作業を実はやってて本当にどれを1で仕上げるかみたいな細かいところまでやってます。で僕は
So he spent about 3 to 4 months on just the sound. And he was very specific with, you know, the sound itself, where to start the sound, where to end it. And he feels that it's not just the music and the sound, but all of it, the dialogue and all of it together makes it into like one big, you know, operatic work. He wanted to become a jazz musician, and so until he was 20.
So
he says that, yeah, he was very difficult, so he had to practice a lot. The movie is about 4 children, but he wanted to make it feel like the audience was the 5th member. And he wanted to make it feel like the entire audience was one person, like one brain. And so he made that scene so that the entire audience feels like they are, you know, part, yeah, they're the ear, they're the 5th person's ear.
1人の人間、お客さん全員が1人の人間である感覚を作りたくて、劇場を全部こう脳みそというか耳を感じれるシーンを入れたかったのであれを入れてます。そうですね、年代を13歳にしてるのもその異性に対してその性的な
He purposely chose the children's age to be around 13 because it's right before they start, you know, looking at the other gen, like the, you know, before puberty. They start looking at the women or like the other sex sexually. So the kids look at the girl as kind of a mother figure. And it's like their last age to have that kind of feeling of like still kind of respect for like the female character, the female like being. And on the other hand, Ikuko, the girl, is, you know, it doesn't matter to her what the boys think. She'll, you know, kind of grow up on her own.
そうですね、
He wanted to emphasize how the mother figure is, you know, the more important, the significant parenting figure. You know, even if they, you know, have children or not, they always have like this maternal instinct. And, you know, there's something to be respected about that, and he wanted to touch on that. And in Japan, there's this idea that to, you know, really love your mom is, you know how they talk about him being a mommy's boy. It's kind of something that's very uncool. But he wanted to use that to make it look like, you know, give it a, like a kind of cute expression to, you know, think, say that it's okay. So he likes to write down dialogues that he kind of comes up with. He has like a thousand lists in his phone of all these lines, and he thinks that he could probably, you know, put them together and make into a new film. That's how much he has. Yeah.
これからも演技を続けていきたいし、
He definitely wants to continue acting. And because he loves music just like the director, he would love to, you know, work again together.